What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of the Bundesliga Career Mode. This is episode number 8. So we start today's stuff with Ortega, the captain, coming to me and saying he's worried that the transfer window is almost over and we haven't bought anyone in. Well, bro, we got under 1¾ mil. There's no one we really can bring in that's got quality or good potential for the future. But of course, after the injuries to Kruger and Becker in the last episode and three of our loan players getting recalled, I thought, okay, our squad's really small. We've got to get some more bodies in here. Let's promote a couple of youth players. And the two we promoted, oh, I'm very excited for these guys. Konstantin Schafer, the highest rated, who does seem to have the highest potential. 63 rated right back, 77 stamina already. Defensively, looks really solid indeed. That's why I'm getting a defensive working up from medium to high. And also Raphael Mai, who looks like a pretty decent, young, pacey winger. 77 acceleration, 76 sprint speed on the left winger. 63 overall, shows great potential. And again, I'm getting that attacking work rate up from medium to high. That should make him better in transition. So, yeah. Two youth players coming out of the academy today, and I've got to say, for that Konstantin Schafer lad, he looks very exciting indeed. Now, of course, we signed two fullbacks in the summer. Joshua Wagnermann, who's playing left back in this team, and Felix Agüero at right back as well. Now, he's 5'10", and centre-back is his secondary position. And with the defensive stats he's got, I don't think there's a reason why he couldn't play centre-back. Now, you know me, I seem to be like girls on Tinder. For me, my centre-backs need to be 6-foot-plus, do you know what I mean? But I wouldn't be against trying him as a centre-half in this team because of our defensive woes this season as a smaller, traditionally smaller, centre-half in this side. But I'm also thinking maybe holding mid with the good stamina he's got and defensive ability. Train the defense and work out at the high. He could be a good ball-winning midfielder. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Still, first game of today's episode, Eintracht Frankfurt away from home. And off just one win in our last seven, losing Kruger, our joint top scorer, losing Becker for 2 months as well. We needed a change of fortune heading into this game. Having said that, I talk about it often. It's all about perspective. Yes, one win in seven, it's not great. But to be fair, no defeats in our last six games. Unbeaten for six, our longest undefeated stretch all season long, and up to 10th in the table. It's not been a terrible run, if not a great one. But trailing by a goal, we'd had a couple of chances on the counter. Missed a golden one for Okagawa, but 36 minutes in. Oh, mate, I am telling you right now, I love our attacking midfield front three, if you count the wingers as attacking mids just on the wings. Robin Hack and Wimmer as our inside forwards in this team. They're brilliant. And Okugawa as the playmaker. Well, I briefly touched on it in the last episode. If our form does take a sharp decline once again, and we need to change to a 4-3-3 false nine, I think I could get the best out of those three players there in the absence of Becker. But to be fair, if it's not broke, don't fix it. So after no defeats in our last six and trailing here to Frankfurt, Robin Hack turned the game on its head single-handedly. And our young German, transitioning now as players on left wing, gets his sixth goal in 20 games, averaging one in just over every three. He, Okugawa, and Wimmer. I briefly touched on it in the last episode. I want these guys to stay with us as part of our core throughout the entire series. I love them all, man. They're absolutely brilliant. And even when we're not scoring goals for our main striker, with obviously Kruger going down now, it's great to know these guys can get the goals for us. Still, 58 minutes in, we would get ourselves our third, and the game had been completely turned on its head at this point. It was great to see it as well, because I just touched on it there. Kruger was the only official striker we'd had this season that had scored a goal. Lazme, who to be fair has barely got any minutes, Klaus, Arminia Bielefeld's record goal scorer, and Sarah. All three of them had yet to score a goal this season, but Sarah in this game finally turned up in the absence of Kruger. Got a goal, his first of the season, plus an assist as well, and a big 3-1 victory there, our second in three. And now no defeats in our last seven games as well. And for Bielefeld, the big win, as you can see by the table as January comes to an end, puts us in the top 10. So I was thinking, all right, here we go. Only 5 wins in 20, but now in the top 10, getting some separation between the bottom three. That was the most important thing and the best undefeated stretch of the season so far. So in the last episode I talked about it, it's getting harder. We got a smaller squad now. We had those three players that were loaned in that have all been recalled. Two of our regular starters, Kruger, our joint top scorer, and of course Becker going down with long-term injuries as well. Well, Becker's case is a 2-month injury, but even so, I decided not to make any moves on transfer deadline day. Again, we had 1.75 million in the budget, but I decided to keep the cash there, and I'm going to have it carry over until the new season. As Calvin Phillips goes to Juve, how about that for a transfer? But yeah, I'm going to have the transfer budget carry over into next season's budget and not make a big move. I thought I can't really afford to sell any players due to our small squad, and if I was going to bring someone in, with all due respect, 1.7 mil doesn't really get you very far nowadays in modern football. So I think I made the right call there. Keeping the money, it'll carry over into next season's budget. And when you look at our youth squad now, again, no one really jumps out at you in terms of potential and overall. Ludwig, the young wingback, does look like the best in this team so far, but poor overall to begin with. I've got to say, I trust this team. No defeats in seven. Finally getting a foothold after a really poor run of form. We were only just a couple of points on the drop zone, but now into the top 10. Listen, there's a long, long, long way to go. If we can keep this form up, the most important thing to me is just getting away and as far away as possible from that bottom three. Still, in terms of Konstantin Schafer, now I touched on this earlier. I said this guy could be turned into a different player in this team and not a right back. I don't want to sacrifice the development of our two new signings in Wagnermann and Agu. Wagnermann's been really consistently good all season long. Already got his first goal for the club that came against Dortmund earlier on the season. Playing left back, he's doing really well there on the other side of the pitch. Felix Agu is growing really nice as well, now at 73 overall. I like them as our fullback duo for the years that go by. And Schafer doesn't have as much pace as the two, doesn't have as much energy as the two of them, which of course to me and in modern football is essential on wingbacks. But I think as a defensive midfielder, this guy could potentially thrive in a new role through the middle of the park. I briefly touched on it earlier, but I think with the stats he's got, the stamina, get the defensive work rate up to high, shouldn't take too long. I think as a DM in this team, that could be the future for Konstantin Schafer. And I was just sitting there thinking, am I Pep Guardiola in disguise? Do you remember when he came to Bayern Munich and he talks about Philipp Lahm as being one of the most intelligent footballers he's ever worked with, which is a heck of a statement for Guardiola, considering the talent he worked with and the great minds he worked with at Barcelona. To say that about Philipp Lahm was not a surprise, though. One of the greatest fullbacks of all time. If you remember, during the Guardiola era, he transitioned him to play as a defensive midfielder, not all the time, but for quite a bit of it during his time in Munich. I think Schafer could be the next Philipp Lahm in German football, from right back to holding mid, doing both positions flawlessly. Well, in this game, he started as our defensive midfielder against Mönchengladbach. We got battered by them at Borussia Park. I was looking for revenge, and after no defeats in seven, I wanted to extend the unbeaten run. Hack gave us the lead in the first half, but this was so unfortunate. Second half, Mönchengladbach looking for their 11, and they got it as well. Shot off the crossbar, header turned in on the rebound. They almost won it with the final touch of the game as well. Corner whipped in, header goes wide, and in the end, it finishes a 1-1 draw. So it's another draw, and it's been a crazy, crazy run from Bielefeld. In these eight games, we've won, I think, two, but we've drawn six draws in eight games. But I'm telling you, while some people will tell you know, draws aren't worth that much nowadays, I always talk about it. A point is a point. It still goes on the board, you know. Don't get me wrong, if you're, you know, chasing a championship, draws can feel like defeats because most of the top teams are going to win, you know, most weeks. But when you're mid-table or bottom half of the table, a point at times can be really, really valuable. And considering Mönchengladbach are one of the better teams in the division, we got thrashed by them at Borussia Park 5-1, I think it was. That's a good point there. It extends our unbeaten run to 8, and we continue to just gradually, even if it's just one point more, just gradually get away from that bottom three. I'll take it. The undefeated run continues, and some positives once again as we continue to keep teams at bay in what is our best stretch of this season. So following game, Hoffenheim away, and this was a massive one. Coming away from home, taking on Hoffenheim right now. They are struggling down the bottom of the table, in the bottom three, and desperate to avoid relegation. They came to this game playing as though their season depends on the result of this one. They had the first couple of chances as well. Nicolo Zaniolo causing problems here, rolling through to Farias. Great save by Ortega again, though. Two good stops by our shot stopper early, as it was still 0-0. I'd barely woken up in the first half an hour of this game. You know, there's some games we just start off so sluggish, so lethargic. This was one of them. I needed to change things around. And 32 minutes in, as Okugawa beats his man. Oh, I'm just absolutely loving this guy. I really am. 8 goals in the season for our number 11 already. And 32 minutes in, we take the lead against a run of play. Okugawa, Hack, and Vimmer. I want all three of these guys to be with us as the years go by. This guy is so much better than his stats suggest. 18-20, that's just under one in every two. He has been brilliant this season for both setting goals up and scoring them as well. So in front, and 20 minutes after the restart in a very cagey game here. Both teams have played all right, but no one was looking clear out-and-out winners at this point, despite us leading. We saw another injury as Serra goes down. And with 8 minutes to go, after Offenheim had totally ran out of steam despite their fast start, we come on the counter after a great claim by Ortega from Zaniolo's long-range free kick. And as Lasme, off the bench for the injured Serra, takes a touch, gets the ball out of his feet, I was thinking, finally, we're getting some other strikers getting goals. Previously, only Kruger had scored out of our list of four strikers, but now Serra's got one, Lasme's got one, and it's 2-0. Bielefeld. Massive, massive win against Hoffenheim. It gives us more separation between the bottom three. And listen, whilst I'm sitting there dreaming of holding on to a top 10 finish, when you look at the table in just a moment's time, well, it hadn't really crossed my mind. But after no defeats in our last 9 games, and our best stretch of the season, Armenia Bielefeld, with just 12 games to go, are only 2 points off a Europa Conference League spot. Let's not get ahead of ourselves, but the best run this season gains a separation from the bottom three and now knocking on the door of a European place. But that will end season of the Bundesliga career, guys. Big thank you for watching. Enjoy, if you haven't, please drop a like. Most love to you all. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you for the next episode of the Bundesliga career mode very soon.